Welcome back. So next up in my modifications of the Millennium Falcon model are the hazard lights, which are on the underside of the ship, and you can see the positions of them here on this diagram. Now I've been trying to figure out for a while exactly how I was going to do these. I intend on using fiber optic with the red LED light, and have the fiber optic sticking out of the bottom, but that alone won't do it for me. You can see in these photos some of the hazard lights that I'm referring to. However, you'll also notice in these close-up photos that they are actually light housings or fixtures. They're small cylindrical shaped housings with holes around the circumference, and that's actually where the light's coming from. I've seen, you know, a bunch of other Falcon models such as this one where people, you know, just have the fiber optic poking through with red light, which doesn't look bad at all. And you know, don't get me wrong, I'm not bashing anybody for doing it that way. And I've seen some people put little washers around them to make it look a little more like there's an actual light or something. But I want mine as close to the real thing as possible. So by complete fluke, I came across these wire ferrules. And when I saw these, I thought the shape and the size would be perfect for what I wanted to try to do. So I bought a bunch of them. So to start with, I'm taking a hammer, lightly tapping on the center pin to remove the pin from the ferrule. And once all of them were removed, I need to cut them down because they're a little bit too long for the housing. So using a mini miter saw, I cut the ferrules almost in half. Eventually winding up with what you see here. And at this point, I drew points around the circumference of each ferrule with a Sharpie to mark where I want to Dremel out some holes for the light to shine through, trying to keep them as evenly spaced as possible. So then I take the red fiber, put it inside a painted one, and not too bad looking. It's not exactly perfect like I would like, but it's okay. So in looking online of some references of the caution lights, I actually came across somebody on Shapeways who 3D printed some screen accurate lights that are to scale for this model that I'm currently doing. So I ordered a bag of them, and I think these are going to work out perfect. They're actually slightly smaller than what I was making out of the wire ferrules, so it'll actually even be better, screen accurate and more to scale. So to start with, I'm going to take all these little suckers and put them on the end of some toothpicks and line them up on my piece of foam so that I can paint them all at once. So I'm gonna shoot them with a coat of black paint first, because I want to make sure I block all light so that no light actually comes through the plastic itself, only through the little slits. Then I'm giving it a shot of gray primer, which is actually about the color they need to be, so it's just gonna be primer and black paint. And I'm drilling holes for them to fit inside of all around the lower hull, as I had mentioned at the beginning of the video. So the hole is a 2mm hole. And then I'm putting some super glue around the inside of the hole. And then taking the caution light housing and gluing it into place. And I have all of them mounted into the areas where they belong, as you can see in these shots. And once glued into place, inserting my fiber,
And then what I'm doing is I'm using a heat gun to bend the fiber so that it can stay low and so that I can run it to my red LED light source that I'm going to be using to light all of the caution lights. So I'll get it into position. I'm just going to use regular old Elmer's glue to glue the fiber in place. I don't want to use anything harsh like super glue, and hot glue actually melts the fiber, so this will just be enough to hold it in place. I also found online these little wire holders, which I'm going to use to neatly secure the fibers to the lower hull. And here I have all the fibers installed with the wire holders. So next I need to power these guys. So I have this breadboard here and I have a ton of the little connectors, the same connectors that are used on the actual board that comes with the model. And I'm going to make a board that will light all of my red LEDs to light up the fibers using these cables as well. So I have the connectors glued in place on the board and I cut some tubing for little standoffs. And gonna screw in the standoffs on the bottom of the board so that it's elevated when it's sitting on the bottom of the model. And here we are with all of my standoffs secured. And it'll fit right into here, and then I'll probably hot glue the standoffs to the lower hull. The other issue is I'm putting my power cord here so that when I have it mounted, but the button that turns it on and off is supposed to go all the way over here. So I need to extend that cable. So I'm gonna snip the cable so that I can extend it over there and leave the power plug here. And I have this green wire, which I'm gonna cut a chunk of to put in between to extend that power switch. So I've gotten that done. I just soldered the length of wire in between, so now I can have the power button on the outside like it's supposed to and have the power plug on the inside where I want it. So I've soldered my sockets together on my board, and I'm going to put some hot glue onto my standoffs so that I can secure the standoffs to the lower hull of the model. And I'm just going to glue it into place here, right next to the real board. And there we go. And I also made an additional board for the four landing lights that come with the model, which go on the outside, and I've glued it down on the other side of the board. And I've made these extension cables here to plug in from the main board that comes with the model kit to go over and power my board. And this Y adapter here I made also that works with the ramp lighting. So I'm gonna plug into one of the ports here to run power over to this board here, which I'm actually gonna make this board my caution light board. So now it's gonna get power from the main board. And then I'm gonna use my Y adapter cable and plug it into the socket that turns on and off the ramp light when that is activated, which is separate from the rest of the power of the model. And then that line is going to go over to my other board, which will power up all of the landing lights. That way when I turn on the ramp, my landing lights will come on. If I turn or raise the ramp, my landing lights will shut off. They won't be all the time while the Millennium Falcon's in flight. So now I'm going to plug in my red LEDs for my caution lights and just do a quick little test and make sure that the red LEDs will light up my caution lights using the test button. And the fibers light up, running to all my caution lights. Here they are, lit, all glued into place, and I'm really liking the way this is looking. It's very screen accurate to the Millennium Falcon. So next up, I'm going to screw in the landing lights, which actually came with the kit and is part of the kit. It's just the caution lights that I've added on my own, as well as all the lighting for the hold from my other video. So these landing lights get screwed into position on the lower hull where they have supplied the light and the screws. And now I have all four lights secured and it's time to plug them into my power board. And again, these landing lights will only be activated if the ramp is activated, the boarding ramp. Because mine will be displayed in the flying position, so most of the time the landing ramp will never be down. Just kind of an added feature. And a little test again. Ramp goes down, lights up, and all the landing lights come on. And they shut off when I raise the ramp. And it came with a remote. There's a little test with the remote. And everything is working exactly like I had planned. So now that all of that is done, next up I have the sublight engines. These are the housings which just need to be pieced together with the wire running through it for the LED strips that they supply with the model kit. This also is part of the kit. This is not an addition that I am doing on my own. And it's just running the wire inside and then screwing the two halves together. Now that they're screwed together, peel off the LED strip backing and actually secure it to the housing. One thing you will notice is there is a gap on the right hand side. The LED strips they supplied don't quite fill the entire housing. You can see right here this area. So my plan is I cut out a little groove and I have an extra strip of LED lights and I'm using three of them to bridge the gap there in the middle so that my lights will go completely from end to end and there won't be any variation of light when the model is lit. So next is just screwing the sublight housings into position. And now it's just securing down my little three LED strip that I cut out to fill in the gap in the middle so that the light will be evenly dispersed across the entire engine. And then plugging in the LED strips, and it's time for a little test lighting. There we go. It's working. It'll be nice and evenly lit all the way across. There won't be any gaps in the engine.
So thanks for watching again, and I'll be having another video posted very shortly.